Hello learners, I am Dr. Vishal Sood, teacher educator. In this unit, we have studied about universalization of elementary education and many projects started for achieving the target of universal elementary education in our country. Today, we are going to discuss about another project which was started by the government of Rajasthan to achieve the target of universal elementary education. This project was Lok Jumbish. So today we are going to learn about another project, that is Lok Jumbish in Rajasthan. So before starting the discussion on Lok Jumbish project, let us have an overview of today's discussion on what points we are going to discuss about Lok Jumbish. First, we will discuss about the Lok Jumbish, how this project came into existence. Then we will go about the objectives of Lok Jumbish project. Then the core and working strategies of Lok Jumbish project will be discussed by us. Then implementation mechanism of this project, the campaigns launched under Lok Jumbish project will be discussed. And in the end, we will discuss about the intervention strategies which were, or the activities which were launched under Lok Jumbish project. And the last part of this discussion will be devoted to the major achievement of Lok Jumbish project as a result of launch in the state of Rajasthan. So our main points will be these for today's discussion. So first of all, Lok Jumbish. Lok Jumbish literally means People's Movement for Education for All. This project was launched in 1992 by government of Rajasthan with the support of Swedish International Development Authority, that is SIDA. The main emphasis of this project was on girls' education and their development. So we can say that this project was a people's movement for providing education to all and achieve the target of universal primary education in the state of Rajasthan. Special efforts in this project were made to link the children belonging to disadvantaged communities with the elementary education. So this project was had a main stress on linking elementary education with the development of the children, those children who belong to the disadvantaged communities in the state of Rajasthan. In this project, people's participation for universal primary education was solicited and maximum community participation was ensured to make this project a success in the state. This project was implemented with the help of voluntary agencies taking care of a cluster of villages. Now, what was done in Rajasthan while launching of this project, that the voluntary agencies were involved, the non-governmental organizations were involved, and those voluntary agencies and those NGOs were entrusted the responsibility of certain number of villages, a cluster of villages, who were responsible for implementing this Lok Jumbish project to achieve the target of universal primary education. So now, before going ahead on this discussion regarding Lok Jumbish project, let us have a watch of video clip which was developed by the World Bank.
This is Rajasthan, the place where I live. But this is also Rajasthan, a place where girls are often treated as a burden. My name is Pooja. My parents married me off when I was 1.5 months old. My grandfather had just died and all our relatives had gathered. So my parents decided to save money on a separate wedding feast later and married me off at that time itself. People in my community think that educating girls is a complete waste. That is why they spend money on sending the boys to school, while girls stay at home and do housework. So, like most women in our tribe, my mother cannot read or write and will spend all her life doing hard labor like this.
This video, you witness that there were a number of problems in the state of Rajasthan, And though these problems were mainly related to not sending of girls to the schools. And the reasons for that is the parents are not willing to send their girl child to the school as compared to the boys. They are willing to send the boys to the school but not to the girls. Due to such problems, this Lok Jumbish project was launched in Rajasthan to empower the women, to make them aware about girls' education so that they can send their girl child to the school and so that they can live their life happily in future. So, as you can see now in these pictures, that the girls, that the women empowerment was the main focus of this Lok Jumbish project in the state of Rajasthan. If the women will be empowered, they will definitely send their girl child to the school, and the gender disparities in elementary education or in primary education, they can be removed. In all of these three pictures, you can see that there are discussions between the women and the local community, and women are taking lead to empower each other, to share their experiences, and this all was done in this Lok Jumbish project so that the girls' education can be improved to a satisfactory extent in the state of Rajasthan. Now, what were the objectives of this Lok Jumbish project? We will discuss about those objectives. The first objective of this Lok Jumbish project was to achieve education for all by the year 2000 through people's mobilization and their participation. Now, this project laid special emphasis on people's mobilization, the community mobilization, the community participation, so that the goal of EFA, that is education for all, or the goal of universal primary education could be achieved by the year 2000. So, this was the first objective of Lok Jumbish project. Then the second objective of this Lok Jumbish project was improving the enrollment of girls and empower women by making education an instrument of equality. That means education should act as a tool for bringing equality. That equality is on the basis of gender. That equality is on the basis of social category. So, improving the enrollment of girls and empower women was the second objective of this Lok Jumbish project. Learners, the third objective of this project was, that is, education for development of children with disabilities, and those children with disabilities who belonged to the minority communities. Means there was the provision of integrated education for disabled, and the children belonging to the minority communities and the disabled children who were belonging to the minority communities, they were the special focus of this Lok Jumbish project. Now, the fourth objective of this Lok Jumbish project was improving the literacy levels up to 80% in the age group of 15 to 35 years in each gender and the disadvantaged section of the society. That means this project has also focused on improving the literacy state of the Rajasthan state, and the literacy rate of this state was very down at that time when this project was launched. So, this was also one of the main focus, that is to improve the literacy levels for women as well as for male population as well as for the population belonging to different categories of the society. Then the other objective of this Lok Jumbish project was making 3 hours relevant to the living conditions of the people. 3 hours means first is writing, the second is reading, the third is arithmetic. So, writing, reading and arithmetic, making these 3 hours relevant to the living conditions, these the writing, the reading work and the arithmetic work should be related to their life. This was the another objective of Lok Jumbish project. Then another objective of this project was improving the quality of primary education and improving the learning levels of students, and for this the provision was made in this project for achievement of minimum levels of learning by the children. Another objective of this project was development of school buildings through local participation. the local people, the local communities were involved in creating the infrastructure, were involved in creating the school buildings. So this was also one of the objectives of Lok Jumbish project. Then for the out of school children, for the children who cannot come to the regular schools, another objective was formulated in this project, and that objective was the provision of non-formal education for the children who were out of school or who were working class children. So these were the main objectives of Lok Jumbish project in the state of Rajasthan. As you can see in these pictures, that for ensuring the local community participation, for ensuring the local people wisdom in the task of the elementary education, the community was involved in this project, and their participation, their say was ensured in this project, so that a feel of oneness, a feel of personal belonging can be emerged among the local people regarding the education. Now, the learners, we will discuss about the core strategies which were adopted in Lok Jumbish project. The core strategies, as you can see on the screen, the first core strategy in Lok Jumbish project was debureaucratization and decentralization of decision making in the sphere of primary education. That means this project laid much emphasis on decentralization of authority. The decision making was filtered to the grassroots level, so the local people's say could be enhanced to the maximum level, and they can share their experiences for providing education to the children. So debureaucratization and decentralization were the main core strategies of this Lok Jumbish project. Then another core strategy which was adopted in this project was creating structures, forums, partnerships between people from the village level community on the one side and the educationists and the NGOs on the other side. Now, creating structures, forums, partnerships, that means there was the provision of bringing the local level community, the village level community, and the educationists and the NGOs on a common platform to share their experiences, so that they can contribute in a cooperative manner, in a coordinated manner, to the development of primary education in the state of Rajasthan. This was also one of the core strategies of Lok Jumbish project. Now, what were the working strategies which were adopted in Lok Jumbish project? We will discuss about those working strategies. Those working strategies in Lok Jumbish project were the development of textbooks according to the local needs. In this project, the textbooks were developed by the state of Rajasthan by keeping into consideration the local needs of the people. The second working strategy which was formulated, which was adopted in this Lok Jumbish project, was the development of local educators and the trainers to motivate teachers. In order to motivate teachers to perform their roles in an effective manner, the provision was made, the strategy was adopted to involve the local people, the local educators, the local trainers, so that they can encourage the teachers to perform their role in a satisfactory manner, and the target of universal primary education can be achieved to a higher level. Then the other working strategy was engagement of more volunteers in order to appropriate conduct of different girls' education related activities. For satisfactory conduct, for proper conduct of the activities which were related to the girls' education, more volunteers were engaged in this Lok Jumbish project, and more volunteer participation was sought in this Lok Jumbish project. Then Praveshotsav, this was a working strategy in this Lok Jumbish project. This Praveshotsav means creation of positive and the creative environment for education of the community, for education of the children. A strategy was adopted to create a positive, a favorable, a conducive, a congenial, a creative environment for the education of the children and the community. And this was a function which was celebrated in the schools when there were admission time and the people were made aware, and interested about the education. So these were the working strategies which were adopted in Lok Jumbish project. Now, what was the implementation mechanism which was adopted in Lok Jumbish project? We will discuss about that implementation mechanism. As you can see on the screen, that this project followed bottom to top approach. Bottom to top approach means, this means that the people at the bottom level or the community or the teachers working at the grassroots level, they were involved in the decision making process. The process was participatory in nature. The people from the village community were involved in the education affairs, the primary education affairs, and then the feedback received from the bottom level, from the grassroots level, was incorporated in the plans or the schemes which were formulated at the higher level. So this was the bottom to top approach which was followed in Lok Jumbish project. Then the committees at grassroots level were framed. These committees involved first village education committee, then prerak dals were framed, Bhavan Nirman Samiti. Bhavan Nirman Samiti means for construction of the school buildings, special committee was created for ensuring community participation, for ensuring the parental involvement in elementary education affairs. The committees were framed at the grassroots level and their involvement was taken in the decision making process at the school level so that different activities related to the schools can be organized in an effective manner, in an appropriate manner. Then the other implementation mechanism, that Adhyapika Manch were created for improving the participation of women in education. The women teachers, the local women, the women belonging to the self-help groups, they were involved. The women, for women teachers, the Adhyapika Manch was created in Lok Jumbish project so that the participation, the involvement of women in the elementary education affairs, in the educational affairs of the villages could be improved to a greater extent. Then the provision, the mechanism was adopted, that was the school mapping and micro planning at the village level. School mapping and micro planning, that means the structure was framed that a particular school is catering to what type of population, what type of educational facilities are available in the school. Those facilities were identified and the planning was done at the village level, at the micro level, so that the real inputs from the grassroots level could be incorporated in the plans, in the schemes which were formulated at the higher level. So school mapping and micro planning was also one of the implementation mechanism that was adopted at the in this Lok Jumbish project. Now, what different campaigns were launched under Lok Jumbish project? And these, there were mainly three campaigns which were launched under Lok Jumbish project. These three campaigns are, first is the women were encouraged to contest elections for the Panchayati Raj institutions. The women were motivated to take part in the process of democracy, in the process of Panchayati Raj institutions, they were motivated to contest elections. The second campaign which was launched under Lok Jumbish was the capacity building of villagers in general and women in particular. The local community members were trained, were oriented, the women in particularly were oriented regarding the benefits of education. Their skills were upgraded under this Lok Jumbish project. Then under this project, healthcare programs in schools were run, and these schools were situated in 102 villages in the state of Rajasthan. So three campaigns were launched. First was motivating the women, to contest the elections for Panchayati Raj institutions to be a part of the democracy. Then the skill upgradation, the capacity building of local community and women in particular, that was done, and healthcare programs in the schools were run. So these were the campaigns. Now, what interventions were made under Lok Jumbish project in the state of Rajasthan? The major interventions, as you can see on the screen, first was the hostel for tribal children. For tribal children, the hostels were constructed, the hostel were established. And these hostels were catering educational needs of seasonal immigrants in the state of Rajasthan and remote people in the state of Rajasthan. So for tribal children, for meeting their educational needs, who can shift from one place to another by on the basis of the different seasons, on the basis of different weathers, for them the hostels were established so that the children belonging to these communities, the tribal communities, the seasonal immigrants, they can stay at one place and can receive education. Then the other intervention was Mahila Shikshan Bihar. Mahila Shikshan Bihar was an intervention under which the residential courses for out-of-school girls who could not attend schools because of one or the other reasons in the rural areas, and those girls who were belonging to the age group of 15 and higher age group, for those girls, Mahila Shikshan Bihars were established and residential courses were started for those girls. Then Balika Shikshan Shivirs were started in this Lok Jumbish project. These Balika Shikshan Shivirs were the residential camps of 6 to 8 months. These camps of for providing education were only for the period of 6 to 8 months for the girls who were in the age group of 9 or above years. And those girls who have dropped out from the formal system due to any reason, for their re-entry to the formal system, these residential camps known as Balika Shikshan Shivir of 6 to 8 months were started under Lok Jumbish project. Then another intervention was Muktangan. As you can see on the screen, this Muktangan intervention was an area-specific program for the tribal children, and those tribal children who were in the Kishanganj block of Khandela cluster of the state of Rajasthan. So Muktangan was an intervention started for the tribal children residing in Kishanganj block of Khandela cluster. Then another intervention was Madrasa. Madrasa was an intervention which was initiated to strengthen the education of minority groups, especially the Muslim community in Bharatpur common block of Rajasthan. Then Sahaj Shiksha Kendra was another intervention which dealt with the non-formal education program for fulfilling the needs of working children, the children who belonged to the working community or to the working class or could not come to the regular schooling. For them, the provision was made in Lok Jumbish project to provide them non-formal education, and for this non-formal education program was started, which was known as Sahaj Shiksha Kendra under Lok Jumbish project. Then school health program was there. This school health program dealt with to generate health and hygienic awareness among school children in order to aware the school children about health issues, the hygiene issues, the cleanliness issues. School health program was launched under Lok Jumbish project in the state of Rajasthan. Then another intervention was the Anganwadi centers, which were created under Lok Jumbish project to strengthen the pre-primary education by linking it with the primary education. And for linking of the primary education with the pre-primary education, the NGOs were involved in the state of Rajasthan to achieve the target of universal primary education, the goal of Lok Jumbish project. So these were the major interventions which were implemented under Lok Jumbish project in the state of Rajasthan to achieve the target of this universal primary education. Now, we will discuss about the main achievements of this Lok Jumbish project in the state of Rajasthan. As you can see on the screen, learners, as a result of this Lok Jumbish project, there was increase in girls' enrollment in the state of Rajasthan. The enrollment of girls has started increasing. Parents were willing to send their girl child to the schools. The increase in overall enrollment in the state of Rajasthan from the year 1992 to 1996 was 24% on an average. This project also laid emphasis on the teacher training. The teachers were trained to make people aware about education, to achieve the target of universal primary education, and to improve girls' enrollment in the schools and to reduce their dropout before completing the class 5th, which was also an aspect of universal primary education. Then the women teachers form, that is Adhyapika Manch, was also created under Lok Jumbish project. So these were the main achievements of this Lok Jumbish project in the state of Rajasthan. So this was all about the Lok Jumbish project, which was launched in the state of Rajasthan to achieve the target of universal primary education and to improve the status of girls' education and women education in the state of Rajasthan. And this project laid much emphasis on community participation, local people involvement in the educational affairs. So learners, today we discussed about the objectives of Lok Jumbish project, core and working strategies of Lok Jumbish, the implementation mechanism, the campaigns which were launched under Lok Jumbish project, interventions under Lok Jumbish, and major achievements of this Lok Jumbish project in the state of Rajasthan. Thank you. I hope that you all have understood about different aspects of Lok Jumbish project. Thank you very much.